say Fed Serapisos in what was an incredibly close bout. He's overcome one of his most difficult opponents in David Sancheong in the first round. He pulled a spinning back fist from hell out against Dane Williams in the second. And now he's after the two-time champion, Sonny Vanathy. He is the Filipino kid, Joey Bailon. Joey Bailon is not the tallest man in the world. He needed to take a run up to get over those ropes. And he is a man full of confidence. This is a fight he has chased for some time.
And his opponent making his way to the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, this is Sonny Vanathy!
Sonny Vanathy, the two-time king in the ring, two-time world champion, the elder statesman of the lightweight division. He put on a clinic against Sam Hill, but in the first fight of the evening, he did look a little bit slow. So let's see if he has enough energy, enough resilience, and enough brilliance to take his third King in the Ring title. Originally from Laos, he's based in New Zealand for a couple of decades now. Older, he is taller, and he has a demonstrable experience advantage. Joey Bailon, though, is a fighter reinvented now. He's taken up the southpaw stance, and those 4 years could prove to be decisive. Jason Sonny, well, he's been here before many times with a finalist in King in the Ring. Sonny Vanathy, he's pretty happy and relaxed as well. And this is the calm before
the storm. Once again,
ladies
and gentlemen, this is the final fight of the evening. It is for the championship of the King of the Ring 8-man eliminator 62 kg division. Introducing first, fighting out of a blue corner. He's a former New Zealand WKBF lightweight champion. He represents ETK HQ in Auckland. He now has 28 wins, 13 losses, 3 draws, with 3 big wins coming by way of KO. Introducing Joey, the Filipino Kid, Bailon! And his opponent fighting out of the red corner is a former 2-time New Zealand lightweight King of the Ring champion, representing Archangel Thai Boxing in Upper Hutt. He now has 55 wins, 24 losses, 1 draw, with 12 big wins coming by way of KO. Introducing Sonny Archangel Vanathy! 3-3s with the Maori's referee in charge is Clive Cowley.
Clive Cowley awaiting Sonny Vanathy to come in.
Put the poker on the table. When the guy comes back, put the poker on the table. Yeah, Sonny.
And Sonny Vanathy getting the call to come see in the ring.
Okay.
He looks happy to be there.
At all times, protect yourselves at all times, yeah? You know the rules. Touch gloves, step back, have a good fight, okay?
Joey Bailon. Judge. He's been Judge. The nearly man.
Judge.
Beaten finalist Felix. Last year. Sonny Vanathy looking to retire on a three-peat.
Cowan. Cowan.
3 by 3 minute rounds. The King in the Ring 62 kilo final.
Put that stool out.
Balog coming out of the blue corner with the Mohawk in the white and red. Benathy.
And his archangel, Jim,
gold and black.
Hey! Fight!
And we're underway. Balon the southpaw, Vanathy in the black and gold. Both boys carry tremendous power in their hands. And a couple of acres there. But Balon, nice little switch up there from Sonny Vanathy. Switched up the southpaw after throwing that shot. Balon looking for that left hand. Both these boys quickly moving into setting up with power. Vanathy switching stance. Eats the left hand for a straight, but there wasn't a lot of pepper on it. It was more of a pushing punch from Balon. Balon just needs to double up on his jab a little bit more and control the lead hand. There's a nice little uppercut straight there. Vanathy skips his way out of trouble, takes most of the sting off it. Heavy kicks from Balon, looking for the counter right hand.
I think the way Sonny Vanathy's seeing the shots coming, a single shot or punch is not going to be enough. You're going to have to go with numbers. And it has to be really effective because Sonny is on his game at the moment, showing why he's won this two times.
Balon looking for that right hook that he throws with a great deal of venom. Vanathy picking his shots at the moment. Throwing a lot of fakes too, again, and looking for lead hand control, switches to southpaw. Vanathy using those eyes to get himself out of trouble. Throwing what's known as the same. Kicks with the same hand that he's punching with. A lot of head movement from both boys, but Joe Balon's got to be very cautious. He doesn't dip into a right head kick. Liver kick from Balon. Nice digging left hand to the body. Vanathy just back him up a little bit more. Vanathy actually looks better when he counterfights. Tries to pick Balon off as he comes in. And Balon is a guy who can overreach too, Monty.
Yeah, we normally see Sonny from the outside in the early exchanges today in the opening bouts, but this time he's quite content going early. He get nice and deep in the pocket and look to exchange. Something Joey won't mind either.
He doesn't want to give away a round, though. It's only a three-rounder. He's just at the... There was a hooking right hand again from Balon. He almost throws that from conventional position. And Sonny Vanathy has been hurt to the body. Balon really trying to work there. Now Vanathy will be stung into action. He always tries to steal back the points. Nice work from Balon. Digging right hand there. Well, that's a round you can lock away for Joey Balon. He was busier and he may have hurt Vanathy. Vanathy, when he moved away from his counterfighting game plan, Joey Balon was able to get on the front foot.
Gotta wake up now. You lost that round. You need to win this round if you're feeling like you can have a chance, alright? Stop pacing it, man. You need to work. You can't miss 6 minutes of your life now. You already wasted three, alright?
There's some harsh words in the corner, and boy, did he need them. You need to wake up now. You just wasted 3 minutes of your life.
Change where it is, Joey. We're going forward to the body.
And Jason Suddy calling for a bit of a change-up. So he's setting up with the left kick to the body and then looking for the opportunity to throw it high. Vanathy just didn't have his range there after looking so sharp in the second. Balon's southpaw stance in particular, just offsetting him a little.
I see you, man.
Well, Vanathy came out of retirement for this. He wants to be the only third-time winner and king in the ring in this division. Opportunity missed already in terms of round one.
Balon finding a way with those. That counter-right hook of his, it's quite deceptive. And it's his power hand deep to the body as Balon was kicking. Vanathy needs this round. Balon already one round up. Balon landing, he switches over and almost throws that from a conventional stance. Oh, he was lucky that kick got caught on the shoulder. It had actually looped over the guard. Bailon will take some confidence from that. Oh, a counter right hook, and that one hurt. Benathy, he's backed up straight away. Benathy's been hurt. His guard's tight. He's been hurt badly. There's another right hand against the right. Bailon looking for the finisher. This is where Benathy can be dangerous, though. But Bailon's just overthrowing a little bit. He's just too well just to set himself up. But Sonny Benathy needs to dig himself out of a deep, deep hole right now. All of a sudden, he seems to have aged. That left kick going high from Bailon. Switch up. Right hand off the left hand. Off the left kick, rather, from Bailon. Benathy just can't find his range. He's not dealing well with the southpaw. And Bailon able to ghost his way out of trouble. Benathy needs to throw a right kick after he throws his right hand. And again, some of those things that have we saw earlier, Monty. Just the defence. There's an uppercut that caught Bailon. Just the defence of Benathy as he walks in. That's where he slowed down a little.
Yeah, we saw vintage Benathy in the semi-final leading up into this. The best we've seen. He was exciting. But right now you see Benathy trying to make use of the longer levers from afar. But it's playing catch-up at the moment, isn't he?
Yeah, he switched to the southpaw stance because he's struggling with the switch hitting of Joey Bailon, who's unorthodox. Right hook is really doing some work for him. He's landing it. Benathy just overbalancing. He's not exploding and he's walking in. Another slapping kick from Bailon. Now Bailon just starting to overlean now. But he has to be happy. He knows he's ahead in this fight. Benathy will need an 8 count just to take it to a draw. And you see there, Bailon slipping the right, straight right hand. Benathy needs to double up on it. Straight right hand followed by a right hook. Deep trouble now for the two-time champion, Sonny Benathy. Let's see if his corner can come up with the answer to the riddle that has been Joey Bailon, the switch southpaw.
Last round. That round could have gone either way. Either way. Alright? Get the dick deep and fucking win this fucking round.
Can't he?
You gotta knock this guy out, alright? Like they deliver fighting their full time, you gotta do the same.
The floor across the body is working and it stops him coming
all
in.
All day.
Check it out. Okay, this is a mistake free round. We have a tight card. The tightest game
ever. I do too. Joey Bailon, I think he's up 2 rounds to none. They're talking about stopping Benathy from coming and keeping the right hand busy with the southpaw shin kick. Benathy, though, he does have that power, and it has got him out of trouble in the past. This is the third and final. It's the king in the ring. Lightweight final. Benathy starts off well. There's that right hand there from Benathy. Joey gets himself out of way, though. Muhammad Ali styles. Right hand counter from Benathy. This is where Benathy needs to attack. And he allowed Bailon to get out of the corner there. Nice work from Bailon. Beautiful. Smashes the inside thigh. Just doesn't allow Benathy to set for his right hand, which is his power shot. And again, he's letting him out of trouble. He's just walking forward. He's not cutting his man off.
The problem with Benathy coming forward and trying to throw everything at it and look for the knockout is you leave yourself open. Get your blinkers on. You don't see the opposition coming out with some punches. Don't forget, Joey Bailon can punch. He's got enough power in either arm or even in his legs.
Benathy needs the right high kick. he needs to throw that after he throws his right hand. But right now, Joey Bayline's doing a number on him. Southboard straight left, the low kick from the southboard, dropping it low. Vanathy checked that one, the first one in a while. Vanathy's, he's just trying to set his feet and find a bomb. Bayline using his eyes to get himself out of trouble. A minute 30 to go in the final round. Vanathy just struggling. He's looking for the bomb, but Bayline's not giving it to him. The call from Jason Suddy was for a mistake-free round. He's just got to watch him bobbing his way into the right kick of Vanathy. I haven't seen him throw it yet, but it's there. A minute to go. Straight right started to land for the first time. Now Vanathy's coming on. Bayline tired. Vanathy backing him up to the ropes. He's rocking for the first time. Spinning back fist. Partially taken. Bayline digging deep. Vanathy looking for the finish. Bayline check hooks, gets himself out of trouble. Firing back, smoking the legs of Vanathy. Big knee from Vanathy. Finally, he roars into action. Bayline just needs to get on his bike, and he has his fight, and he's doing it. All he needs to do to win. Vanathy doubling up on his right hand. 20 seconds to go. Vanathy going again with the right hand, eating that. Well, it's been called a slip. 10 seconds to go. Unless he knocks him out, this fight is Joey Bayline. He threw everything with that. Joey Bayline should take this fight. Depending on the second round, but I would have given the first two to Bayline. Most certainly, Vanathy won the third. But stranger things have happened. Bayline feels confident. Let's see if the judges agree. Well, the pregnant pause is over and we are awaiting the decision.
Fighters to the center ring, please.
Joey, Sonny.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, a round of applause for these two finalists, please. After three rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards, where we find a unanimous decision winner. Your winner, fighting out of the blue corner,
the Filipino king has gone one better than last year. He is the 62-kilo king in the ring in the lightweight division. And ETK, Jason Suddy's ETK gym, takes home another title.